Today we're going to talk about Generation C and the new experience of the connected customer. With us today is Julie Bornstein, Senior VP of Digital at Sephora. Welcome.
Hi, thanks.
Thanks for being here. We certainly talk a lot about social media these days, and you're doing very well out there. I think what do you have, 3 million Facebook fans, 500,000 on Twitter. How has social media changed your perspective on digital marketing?
I would say for Sephora in particular, social media is kind of the natural coming to life of a community that has always been very passionate about beauty. And so, you know, we have Beauty Insider, which is our loyalty program, and we have about 17 million women who are part of this program. It's a very passionate, very interested, loves to talk about the product, give advice, and get advice community. So for us, social media has been sort of the coming out of all of that interest and enthusiasm. Also, I would say, as someone who's been in e-commerce for a decade, finally being able to hear sort of the real-time thoughts of our online consumer has been fascinating. So in the stores, they always know right away what's going well and what's not. They're getting constant real-time feedback, and now we have it too. So that's been another very nice element to it.
How has that changed your voice and your approach to talking to customers now that you're part of the conversation and also now that you could hear what they're thinking and saying right back?
Yeah. Our feeling about it is we are there to provide service and also provide inspiration. We think about kind of the whole digital landscape as an opportunity to not only make selling and buying for the client easier, but also really providing another outlet to get educated on product and how to apply makeup and those kinds of things, and also a way to entertain. And so I think our voice is very real, kind of depending on what the consumer is talking about. And so if it's a problem, we deal with it right away. And it's actually been good because even when there is a problem, publicly, everyone can see that we're working hard to try and solve the problem for the customer. And when it comes to marketing, we like to talk about things we're genuinely excited about. And in the social media space, you get a chance to share what is going on and why you're excited about it. So it gives us a chance to go a little bit deeper on what new things are happening and why the consumer should care.
Now, as having responsibility for all of digital, social, I think, has thrown many brand managers in for a loop, in some cases in the sense that they have a style guide that they've operated against, mm-hmm. but not necessarily a brand style guide when it comes to voice or persona or characteristics or mannerisms or vision and mission. How did you approach that?
Well, we started pretty scrappy, and so we didn't have a lot of time to build new style guides. And so we got people who were good writers and who really knew beauty and who really knew Sephora, and we let them just kind of be real and go. And so we didn't put together a lot around style guides. I think on Facebook and in Twitter, you know, you really need to speak the way that that community speaks. And so you need to adjust what it is you're saying and how you say it. We also have a small group in our customer service team that's dedicated to responding to all questions and inquiries and complaints. And I think they try and be as concise as possible while addressing the issue that the customer has.
You brought up some really good points because it's certainly a scrappiness in an approach, but there's a sense of authenticity, there's a sense of transparency. But you also introduced an infrastructure around the social customer. So it's not just about marketing. You mentioned service and you mentioned engagement.
Sure.
So that means that you'd bring a more holistic approach to social media. What was that like on the inside and what did that take to bring into play?
Well, it's interesting. We didn't have sort of a separate marketing team take charge of the social media channels. We did it through our e-commerce team. So while we work very closely with kind of the central marketing team, which is not big, and so it's easy to all work together, we very much perceive it as, you know, the client is interacting in the digital world and we've all been in the digital world. And so it's really about understanding why she's there and what she wants to do when she's there. I think that team living as part of the what was originally the e-commerce, which is now gotten into mobile and tablet and in-store digital. So we're doing a lot. We kind of work together, and I would say it's been a very natural process for us.
You brought up something which is an important point that I want everybody to listen to and better understand, and that is the idea of experience. You're responsible for digital, but you walk into any Sephora store, and even congratulations, by the way, on the JCPenney deal. It is an experience. It's visual, it's auditory, it's sensory. And you've done a very good job of not only bringing that into social media, but across all digital platforms, including mobile. Can you talk to us a bit about what that experience looks like from a strategic standpoint? and how do you bring that to life?
I would say that for us, digital is a means to sort of enable the customer experience with beauty. And we really see ourselves as the owners of digital beauty in that we have this huge community and we really are very focused on how do you look at all the trends that are going on and make sure we're there for our customer wherever she wants to be. And so whether she wants to be on her phone because she's buying or because she's in a store and she wants to scan a product and read the review so she can see what other people are saying, or she is on Facebook and wants to get opinions from her friends on which is the best mascara because she's getting married and she wants a great waterproof mascara, all of that happens very naturally. And for us, digital is very much about facilitating it. And it's kind of about buying as easily as possible wherever you want. It's about entertaining. It's about educating. And it's really all of those pieces that really come together to make sure that it's seamless and it's fun for our client to interact with beauty. It's interesting because one of the top reasons why women choose to buy beauty is because they've sampled the product. So the touch and feel aspect is hugely important for us. And so having our stores is the cornerstone of our brand. But the second most popular way that people decide what products to buy is through friends' recommendations. And that's where digital really comes in play. And we are very focused on how do we help people find the right product for them or get great suggestions from their friends or recommend products they love. And as we look into the future, that will be a continuing cornerstone of how we approach digital for sort of this beauty space.
I like that because it's not just about facilitating a more engaged or holistic experience. It's about steering a more informed experience, mm-hmm. which I think is a role that brands are going to have to think about in the future. Mm-hmm. Before we talk about the connected experience, I have a question for you of how all of this has led to insights that might bring a better, not just online or mobile experience or social experience, but maybe even an in-store experience. How has this changed sort of the folks on the front line?
I think it requires them to be a little more prepared and aware because clients come in armed with a lot of information already. We put a huge emphasis and focus and investment on educating our, what we call cast members, the store salespeople. And, you know, I would say nowadays, clients walk in and they are just as knowledgeable because they've read all the reviews and they've read all the product information. And so I would say it ups the game for everyone. I think we can rise to the challenge well. I also would say it gives them, as we look into the future, more information to help and assist the clients. So whether it's kind of navigational tools in the store to select product that's right for you that they can work together with the client on, or whether it's a device that they have because we have mobile POS and we have Beauty Insider and we have a lot of information. If you forgot what color your lipstick is that you love, is it, you know, shade 11 or 12? We can easily look it up for you. We can help recommend other things for you based on what you've bought or sampled in the past. So it arms them with more information to give even better customer service.
Sephora certainly celebrates a very unique, loyal, engaged community. In my research over the years, I found that there is this new genre of consumer that's emerging. You have sort of the traditional, you have maybe over the last 20 years a digital consumer, now you have this very connected consumer mm-hmm. that I refer to as Gen Z. And Gen Z, unlike the other two groups, well, first, it's the only of all segments that's growing. Mm-hmm. And then also, they, I kind of playfully call them contributing to the ecosystem because they sort of force people, information, and businesses to sort of revolve around them. Mm-hmm. As a result, they expect information to come to them. They expect it not to only be seamless, but frictionless and on demand mm-hmm. and instant. And I'm wondering, what have you observed in this regard in terms of the different classes of consumerism? And then how does that change your digital and also your real world strategy?
It is very clear to us that that is happening. And it is clear to us that we need to be prepared to respond the way we know these consumers want to shop. And so, you know, I would say many of us working on this effort within Sephora live this way also. And so it makes us better at doing our jobs because we're all addicted to all of our devices and we all are starting to expect that. And then many of us have children and we're watching the way they're growing up. And the reality is we're adapting. They have never known a world any other way. And so while we haven't necessarily seen that group come to sort of fruition in our primary consumer base yet, we know it's coming. And it is imperative, I think, for any retailer and any business to be prepared to handle that. And so, you know, I would say all of the efforts that we're doing are very much focused on the fact that We have to keep up with all of the things that are happening and all the ways that our consumer wants to communicate with us. And we have to be sort of scanning the future and figuring out, because none of these things can be done overnight, what the next thing is so that we're there to meet their needs and be there for them. And so it definitely informs our investment in this area.
Wonderful. You have an audience of this program of executives, of those in e-commerce, mobile commerce, even social commerce. You have marketers. You have those who are responsible for user experience. If you had to leave all of them with advice based on your learnings over the last several years, and also what you're looking forward to, what would you say?
It's very different to be in a technology company than to be in a retailer and be the technology arm or the digital arm of that retailer. Obviously, you're dealing with different things. And I think in a retail environment or more traditional business environment where you're paving the way, it's kind of the person who's driving that vision needs to make sure that they are communicating and selling, spending a lot of time getting the rest of the management team as excited as they are about the opportunities. Because bringing real examples to the table gets the team excited, makes them understand that they need to invest. The CEO needs to believe. I think that finding a team who lives and breathes it and everyone is focused on the customer experience, because at the end of the day, whether you're a developer or you're in marketing or you're in the call center and you're responding to customers, you have to think about how is this technology really benefiting them and what are the things that are going to make the difference. And I've always gotten personally really excited about making shopping more fun, smarter, more efficient, simpler, and all of those things I think really excite my team around me too. And so I think getting the right team, figuring out the structure, I mean, certainly everyone who works in a medium to large size company understands the complexities of how an organization is structured and how much that will inform how much they can get done and how quickly they can move. So that's huge, and spending time on that, I think, and making sure that you're sort of balancing between looking forward, spending time with the rest of the management team who may be working on other things, keeping your team focused and motivated and excited, and then really speaking to the consumer on a regular basis and understanding what they're loving, what they're not, and, you know, listening, I think. And there's so many great listening channels now that I think all of those things are important elements as you build a strategy that really leverages digital in the best way for your business.
You mentioned earlier about having to be adaptive, which I actually like, because I think a lot of businesses look to the future as becoming more of a social business, but not necessarily thinking about how to be adaptive for the emerging, say, behavior of Gen Z. What are some of the innovations that you have either put into play or are putting into play to not only be adaptive, but also to lead experiences?
The most recent is that we just relaunched our website kind of from ground zero, and it gave us the opportunity to not only leverage a new technology, but really provide some services that we know our clients are looking for. And so it gives you the ability, first and foremost, to take this massive database of beauty products that we sell across many, many brands on our site and allow you to really intelligently filter through it so you can find exactly what you're looking for. So it's the question of what's good for me is really the question in beauty. There's a little bit of a what my friend likes inspires me, but there's also the question of I have these very specific needs and issues. And so we provide you the ability to really filter through and very intelligently get down to what it is that you're looking for across the board. I would say the other thing that we knew clients wanted is they wanted the ability to very much shop seamlessly. So do their research online or from their mobile phone and then buy it in store when they go to work tomorrow or on the weekend. And so we have the ability for every product on our site. You can see if it's available in your store, so you can do some free shopping beforehand. We also have some fun things, an integration with Pinterest, which we know that there's already a strong overlap because we have a lot of products already pinned by many, many people out there, as many retailers do. And so we're integrating that into our site. And I think we also are taking everything that we're doing on the site and we're making sure that it's available on your mobile phone. So to me, that is no longer really an option. The mobile phone has become the most immediate and most useful tool, certainly in my life, and I think in many consumers' lives. And so everything that we do, we really try and make sure, okay, how do we leverage this best for mobile? And we think of mobile both as a selling channel in and of itself, but really a research channel and a tool to shop in store. So the ability to scan a product and see a review so you can, before you buy, see what other people say. The ability to quickly access your past purchases. So if you can't remember the shade you bought of your favorite lipstick last time. You can look it up quickly. And we give you a little bit of fun. You can see videos. You can see how to put this on. And you can see our staffer, Sephora staffer's daily obsessions. So one person chooses their favorite product and shares it out and tells you why. So we've sort of added, I would say, some bells and whistles to mobile that kind of work in that use case.
So it comes down to vision. Not only for what you see is possible, but also what you see is possible for the customer experience. And it also takes a culture of customer centricity. Once you have that, you have to realize that it's not just about technology, it's about how technology becomes an enabler for that experience. Because it's not just about what you want them to do, it's about making them feel fulfilled, feeling value, and then more importantly, sharing that value with their community. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me.